Some gnats come from the grass to speak with Solomon.
Oh, Solomon.
You are the champion of the oppressed. You give justice to the little guys, and they don't get any littler than us. We are tiny metaphors for frailty. Can you defend us?
Who has mistreated you?
Our complaint is against the wind.
Well, says Solomon. You have pretty voices, you gnats, but remember, a judge cannot listen to just one side. I must hear both litigants.
Of course,
agree the gnats. Summon the east wind, calls out Solomon. And the wind arrives almost immediately.
What happened to the gnat plaintiffs? Gone. Such is the way of every seeker who comes to complain at the High Court.
When the presence of God arrives,
where are the seekers? First,
there's dying. Then union. Like gnats inside the wind.
Thank you.
There is no sentient being. Sentience or consciousness is functioning through the medium of a uniquely programmed body-mind instrument. The world is perceived as an apparent objective reality when the mind is externalized, thereby abandoning its identity with the self. When the world is thus perceived, the true nature of the self is not revealed. Conversely, when the self is realized, the world ceases to appear as an objective reality. That is illusion, which makes one take what is ever-present and all-pervasive, full to perfection and self-luminous, and is indeed the self and the core of one's being, for non-existent and unreal. Conversely, that is illusion, which makes one take for real and self-existent what is non-existent and unreal, namely the trilogy of world, ego, and God. The names and forms which constitute the world continually change and perish and are therefore called unreal. It is unreal, imaginary, to limit the self to these names and forms, and real to regard all as the self. It is immaterial to the enlightened whether the world appears or not. In either case, his attention is turned to the self. It is like the letters and the paper on which they are printed. You are so engrossed in the letters that you forget about the paper. But the enlightened sees the paper as the substratum, whether the letters appear on it or not. Do not try too hard to show your humility. The very effort exposes your pride. True humility lies in the absence of doership. There is no sentient being. Sentience or consciousness is functioning through the medium of a uniquely programmed body-mind instrument. A seeker seeking salvation through a particular path is in fact trying to get out of a hole he has never been in. The effort itself becomes the hole.